Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about React Redux integration in terms of code, like what library you need to have, what code you need to write at the component level to talk to Redux. Okay, so we need to actually have this library first, React Redux we are calling it, npm install or yarn add React Redux. Once you have this, now at the component level, now we can write how to talk to Redux. Okay, so that thing we'll talk about this, what is presentential component and container component. This you can for now understand it. Container component are those components which are actually directly going to talk to Redux. Presentational component are those components which are only going to receive the data and only going to show the data on the UI. Now, in terms of code, what we are going to write, that we can understand from here. Okay. I will just directly jump to that code. I hope this is visible. So I was talking about this particular code. We have two helper methods which Redux is providing. Okay, so we have to create a higher order component. Higher order component are those components which returns another component. So link I created as a component. Okay, maybe a hello world link, header, YouTube list, YouTube video, any component. Okay. What I'm doing is I'm using the connect bridge which is provided by Redux. It is coming from Redux. Okay, and I'm passing these two helper methods, map state to props and map dispatch to props. And this connect is taking two arguments. First is the helper methods, second is the component. Okay, and it is returning another component which we are exporting. This is called as a container component which actually going to talk to Redux layer. So wherever you see the connect, it means this is a higher order component. Okay, these are the two helper methods. Now we talk about the responsibilities of these methods. Map state to props will help us to get the state from the Redux layer. Map dispatch to props will help us to trigger the action to the Redux layer, because we have to send these actions to the reducer to return, give us the new state. And you see the reducers are something like this, right? Here we are setting, okay, here you are actually triggering toggle to do. Toggle to do is somewhere there, right? It will update the state. It will return the new state in the store. We will always already be subscribing the state in our components. So finally, how we are subscribing the state? This is the root code. You can see the root component we have. What we need to do at the component level is we need to put the provider as a wrapper and we need to pass the store. So store we are creating by your calling create store method. First we will get a root reducer by combining the reducers. Then you call create store method, pass the root reducer inside it. You get the store instance. Then you pass the store in the provider. That's it. So now once you do this line, that after this, any of your child component can talk to Redux, but you have to do this first because this is enabling the capability that any of your React component, because we are providing a store, right, as a parent component, as a parent wrapper. So anything which is coming inside app can be a parent component which will have 100 child components. All components can talk to this Redux layer because we have provided a store. Store is everything. It is having the reducers. Now you just need to formulate your actions and send these actions to the Redux using these two helper methods we have, map state to props, map dispatch to props. That will, they will take care of that action, will return the new state. New state will again get published to the components which are inside app. So if you see this method, these methods are very important, map state to props and map dispatch to props. Earlier they look complex, but now they have more simplified. These are the only two helper methods which we need to understand. Any component, like you, this is my component. While exporting from those two components, you can add these two methods in the bottom. Okay, they will add active property in the props of this link component. So you can access the active property there. And whenever the state is getting changed, I mean new state is being returned, active is now true, earlier it was false. All these toggle which are happening in the state will automatically get populated in the link component. So this is how we created a higher order component. Now this we have created, now we understood this. Now let's write our hello world component. you click on Hello World button and we will update the state, and that state we will populate back on the UI. So basic example, we will talk Hello World in Redux in the next video.